Hello, dear students. Today we are going to have the continuation of the same chapter, Physical and Chemical Changes. In science, all possible changes can be classified into two broad categories. They are physical changes and chemical changes. Now, let's learn more about physical change. Physical change is also known as change of state. A physical change is a temporary change in which no new substance is formed and the chemical composition of the original substance remains the same. Even though some of its physical properties like color, state, shape, size, etc. may change. Characteristics of a physical change. No new substance is formed. You might have observed that when a cube of ice is taken out of a refrigerator, it melts into water. If this water is kept back in the refrigerator, it refreezes into ice. This indicates that the properties of water and ice are the same. That is, their chemical composition is same. They both have the formula H2O. On melting of ice or on freezing of water, no new substance is formed. Only the physical state of the substance changes. Second, the change is temporary and reversible. That is, the substance returns to its original state on changing the conditions. Now, let's take some powdered sulfur and gently heat the powdered sulfur in a wash glass. It melts into a pale yellow liquid. Stop heating and allow the sulfur to cool. Molten sulfur quickly changes back to the solid state. This example proves that physical change is both temporary and reversible. Third one, there is no change in mass during a physical change. Weigh a beaker containing some solid wax on a beam balance. Melt the wax and again weigh the beaker. You will find that the two weights are identical. This shows that there is no change in the mass of the substance involved as a result of physical change. Fourth one, there is usually no gain or loss of energy as a result of physical change. Water changes into steam by absorbing a certain amount of heat energy. The same amount of energy is given out when steam changes back into water by giving up its heat. Therefore, we can say that there is no net gain or loss of energy as a result of physical change. Examples of physical change: melting of wax, melting of ice, magnetization of iron, breaking of glass, drying of wet clothes, dissolution of sugar in water, glowing of an electric bulb. Now let's learn about chemical change. A chemical change is a permanent change in which new substances are formed whose chemical composition and physical and chemical properties are different from those of the original substance. In a chemical change, the original substance gives rise to one or more new substances with entirely different compositions and properties compared to those of the original substance.
Characteristics of a chemical change.
First one, new substances are formed.
Take some iron powder and sulfur powder in a test tube and heat them. A gray-black solid is formed, which is not attracted by a magnet and is insoluble in carbon disulfide. That means a new substance known as iron sulfide is formed, which has properties completely different from the properties of iron and sulfur. Iron is attracted by a magnet and sulfur is soluble in carbon disulfide. Iron plus sulfur gives iron sulfide.
Second one, the change is permanent and irreversible.
When a piece of paper is burned, a new substance, ash, is produced. Even when the burning is stopped, the ash cannot be changed back to paper. This shows that the formation of the ash from paper is a permanent and irreversible change.
Third one, there is usually a change in the mass of the original substance.
Take a piece of magnesium in a crucible with a lid. Weigh it and then heat it by opening the lid after short intervals to let the air enter the crucible. When whole of the magnesium is burned, cool the crucible and weigh it again. You will find that the final weight is more than the initial weight. This proves that when a chemical change takes place, there is a gain in the mass. 2mg plus O2 gives 2MgO. In this process, magnesium combines with oxygen to form magnesium oxide. Hence, mass is gained.
Fourth one, the change of energy takes place.
When wood or paper is burned in air, carbon dioxide and water vapor are produced. But at the same time, energy is also released in the form of heat and light. Examples of chemical change: formation of curd from milk, rusting of iron, the digestion of food, the burning of fuel, rotting of eggs, the cooking of rice. The burning of candle is an example in which both physical and chemical changes take place simultaneously. When a candle is lighted, some of the solid wax first melts and turns into liquid. Then it burns to produce a flame. New substances, CO2 and H2O vapor, are formed along with the evolution of light and heat energy. This shows a chemical change. When some of the molten wax drops on the floor, it again solidifies, which shows a physical change. Thus, the melting of candle wax is a physical change, and the burning of wax to produce CO2 and H2O is a chemical change.
Let's learn the differences between physical and chemical changes. Physical change. In a physical change, no new substance is formed and the chemical composition of the substance remains the same. These are changes only in physical properties and state. In a chemical change, a new substance with entirely different chemical composition and properties is formed. Second, the physical change is temporary, whereas the chemical change is permanent. Third, the physical change can be reversed by simple physical methods. But the chemical change cannot be reversed by simple physical methods. Fourth, heat or light energy may or may not be released or absorbed during a physical change. Heat or light energy or both are given out or absorbed during a chemical change. Now, you just explain what will happen if an inflated balloon is brought near a lighted bulb. Is it a physical change or a chemical change? The inflated balloon bursts when brought near a lighted bulb. This is because the air inside the balloon becomes hot, the kinetic energy of its particles increases, the pressure on the inner walls of balloon, and it bursts. It is a physical change. That's all for today's video. Now, let's check today's homework. Take a carrot and cut it into pieces. Now, answer the following questions. Is the change temporary? Is the change reversible? Why is cutting of carrot into pieces a physical change? Write down the answers of these questions in your textbook itself. Thank you.